Hey, what's good, y'all? It's Jay Coffee Talk back. And hold up, man. We got to talk about this. You know what I mean? This ain't the typical kind of story like Jay Coffee Talk normally gets into covering. You know what I'm saying? Because this ain't spilling the tea. This is Jay Coffee. You know what I mean? But check it out, man. Wendy Williams is on some real bullish, man. Like next level foul grind ball ish. And I'm going to break it all down for you guys. Now, check it out. We know the meme master, Mr. Instagram himself, 50 Cent, is always got jokes about everything, right? But I really, truly believe in this situation. I don't think Mr. Meth is laughing. But you see Fifth shared this, meme. It's a little clip screenshot from Power. And someone's like, yo, Meth, so you fucked Wendy Williams? And Fifth put in the caption, yo, just keep saying you don't remember. Now, check it out. Bottom line, Wendy might be telling the truth about this.
When I was locked away at a place that I didn't belong because I'm not an addict, I was addicted to coke and I quit on my own. It took 4 days and I was an eight ball girl by myself. Yeah,
that was something else I wanted to talk about, but go ahead.
You know, with the only thing I did, I smoked a blunt with Method Man while I gave him a bath and it was a one night stand. And
what?
And he'll deny it, maybe not. You know,
that wasn't in the movie.
It wasn't in the movie because Method Man is still very angry at me.
But what?
I don't know. For being me, for telling the truth. It was one night. We were in the club. A fight broke out and gunshots broke out.
You hear her story there, right? Like she took Method Man home to the penthouse. Gave him a bath, smoked a blunt with him. Like, I don't know if she's trying to paint this romantic picture or what the deal is. But y'all know she just dropped this Lifetime biopic movie. And I will not be watching. You guys let me know if you will. But she's basically just trying to raise a buzz around her name with some controversial-ish that's going to hit the headlines. So people will tune into this biopic or whatever. You know what I mean? She's just trying to raise her stock at this moment. And real quick, before I continue on with this whole Method Man situation, you hear her talking about, I wasn't an addict. I just quit on my own. Get out of here, Wendy. You were coked up to the gills, passing out on TV. Like, stop it. Now, listen, I said she might be telling the truth. And when I'm saying that meth hit, okay? But was it this picture that she's, you know, putting out there at the club where there was a fight and her and meth skate, you know, they stayed off in the rafters smoking a blunt and they skated off together in the night and had this special night together? I don't know. In reality, it might have been more like she was just coming through around the way, you know, where Method Man's at, copping her some powder. And, you know, when she was all geeked up, some ish went down. You know what I mean? And, why do I say this? It might have went down that way. And why do I say that she's such a grind ball? Because, like I said, if this did happen, she's just throwing personal business out there on some spilling the tea. Pay attention to me. Go watch my movie-ish. But she really already done violated Method Man on some real grind ball-ish.
I mean, you touched a little bit there, man, on the, you know, going home to the kids or whatnot. I mean, I think your wife was going through a situation just recently, man. How did that resolve itself? Everything all right now?
I'd like to know how you found out.
MTV.
MTV, what did they say?
They said that you were going through something with your wife. Like, I think she was sick or something like that, right?
Yeah, she was sick.
Is she all right now?
I'd like to thank Wendy Williams for bringing that to the masses because she didn't have to go on the radio and say that shit. I like to keep stuff like that private, but yeah, she was sick.
But everything's all right now.
All right. Better than
all right.
What it was.
Well, then that's what's
what?
Up, man.
Definitely
that's what's
better
up.
Than what it was.
That's what's up, man. I know a lot of us go through it, you know what I mean?
I be feeling like, yo, that ain't nobody fucking business right there, though. I'm sorry. That's just how I feel about it and shit. That's her business. She didn't want anybody to know about it. You know what I'm saying? And I respected her wishes right there. So for the media to bring that and put that shit out there like that, I think that shit is mad tacky and disrespectful.
Yeah, well, you know what, we won't even run that, man, so don't even worry.
No, y'all can run that. I want that to be ran. I'm talking about as far as the way it was done in the beginning, because she's past all that now. But when it was going on and all that and people, it was done by, I'm going to give you, Wendy Williams did it. alright? Her, she's the one that did it. You can attack me any way you want to. I'm in the entertainment business, but you don't attack my family, man. My wife ain't had nothing to do with that, man. Had all nothing to do with that. You did not have to do that. Her family members didn't even know she was sick. We still live in our same community where we used to live at. The people that lived around her didn't know she was sick till you said that shit. Everybody looking at her, staring at her. You know how uncomfortable that makes somebody feel, especially somebody that's going through chemo? Stupid ass bitch. Bad enough she didn't have her hair on her head. You think she wants people staring at her, pointing at her, talking about how sick she is? Nobody knew anything until Wendy Williams said that shit.
She doesn't want a lot of fans, man.
She doesn't have any fans, and the people that listen to her are just as fucking dumb, because the bitch is an idiot, man. She's a fucking idiot, man. It's like she can say whatever she want to say about me. I never call up there for shit. She can say whatever she want to say. You don't attack my fucking family, man. You gotta be out your fucking mind, lady. For real, you gotta be out your motherfucking mind, man. I ain't no regular okey-doke nigga, man. I ain't no insane Justin Timberlake-ass nigga, man. Come from Park Hill, Staten Island, Park Hill, nigga. You been on my block, you know where I'm from. You been on my block, these fucking little niggas around there. Think I don't know snipping blow, sucking these niggas off and shit, I know. However you wanna do it, Wendy, but me? I'm not gonna do it verbally. I'm not gonna come on your little show and try and bark on you and shit like that. Nah, man, I'm a street nigga.
I don't know if y'all remember that, but some years back when Method Man was going through a very personal situation. And listen, this hits close to home with me too as well. If you guys are Team Coffee and rock with the channel and been here for a minute, you're already knowing, you know what I mean, that cancer, I give advice at how to battle it. Once again, I don't have any CURES's. I just have advice. Y'all can tap in with me about that if you know anyone needs that information. But I know a lot of people out there can relate. We've lost loved ones. You know, it's a horrible thing. It destroys families. And you know, when Method Man and his wife are going through this situation, and you heard Matt that they wanted to keep private. You know what I mean? They're well known in their neighborhood. I mean, they just wanted their privacy respected, period. But you heard Matt, they know everyone in their neighborhood and everything. And she's going through what she's going through, and they're going outside and people are looking at them, and how uncomfortable that made Matt's wife feel and everything. Like, that's some real sleazeball, greaseball is for Wendy Williams to pull. And I don't know the chronology or whatever, the order that these events went down, but I would bet if meth did indeed smash, right, Wendy Williams did that out of spite, because she probably wanted more from meth. You know what I mean? She probably hit him up again and he was ignoring her or whatever the case may be. She wanted more out of just a casual encounter that went down, if it did indeed go down, you know. So then when Method Man's wife is sick and it's not being shared in the press, they want their privacy respected, Wendy Williams is going to go out there and speak on that? That's so grimy to me. Like, hit the comments, guys. Let me know what you think about that. Like, that makes me sick. Wendy Williams, you're so foul. You always want to have the scoop and spilling the tea and all this stuff. And you violated Method Man and his wife. And for that, you ain't ish. I'm sure people out there can relate, though, that there's a lot of times that if, you know, two individuals, you know, have an encounter in a one night stand type deal, and the other person, like, men do it to women too. I'm just not, ladies, I'm not hating on y'all, you know what I mean? Because men do it to women too, where, you know, the one, it's just something that happens one night in partying or something, and then when the other person reaches out later on, that, you know, the other one's like, hey, you know, what happened, it is what it is, you know what I mean? Feelings get hurt. And you know, I'm not knocking anyone that happened to, you know what I'm saying, men or women or whatever. It's just to go out and hold a grudge. Like, obviously Wendy Williams is holding a grudge, is if she's gonna go and put meth in his wife's personal business out there, right? And then later on down the road, here where we are now in 2021, when she's trying to get a buzz around her name for her movie, she's gonna put this out there too. Like, hey, come on, get Method Man off your mind, Wendy. Like, get yourself together. You're on some real sleazy, greasy stuff, man. And I have no respect for this at all. Y'all hit the comments and let me know if you guys agree. But you heard Meth when he was putting that message out there to her about, like, Wendy, how dare you do that? You know what I mean? He's like, hey, you want to play? We can play. You know what I mean? You came around the hood, you know, the cat's on the corner slanging you that white girl. You know what I mean? We heard about you getting down and doing some things. You know what I'm saying? Like, you heard what she was saying. She was Mrs. 8 Ball. You know what I mean? They're like, yo, we can knock 20% off the price of this 8 Ball if you want to grab your ankles. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like Wendy, we can knock 25 off if you want to get on your knees. You know what I mean? Like, and then she's out here painting this picture like her and Method Man had this romantic getaway together on the low. Like, stop it, Wendy. You was coming through around the way and getting your fix. And listen, for those regulars to the channel, I apologize, guys. Y'all know I don't talk nasty and foul like that. You know what I mean? I'm not that dude, but this has just got me turned up and quite disgusted on Wendy Williams' part that all these years later, she's still trying to, you know what I mean, play games with Method Man and, you know, mess up his life and everything. And once again, she's disrespecting his wife again. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, man. I just really don't find this. I find this a very poor taste on her part. F her movie. Yo, let's boycott the Wendy Williams movie, y'all. Like, who's down? Hit the comments. Let me know your thoughts about all this. New viewers, make sure to sub to the channel. I thank y'all for tuning in. It's Jay Coffee Talk. I'm signing out, guys. Have a great day. F you, Wendy Williams, and I'm gone.